no stopping us now. Let that song.
G'day folks, welcome to Big V TV. Great to have your company. It's the last regular show of the season.
Thanks for watching.
But we're back next week. That's the big news.
Oh yes, we are.
We're back next week.
Sure, everyone's like, yeah.
Well, to the two people that we know out there that do watch the show.
Will Taylor.
We're going to be back next week. A Big V TV silly season starts next week.
Does.
It'll run right throughout the summer months.
Going to have the latest rumours on who's going where, what's going on around the league in
bit
the off-season.
Bit of a panel sort of set out.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, speaking of rumours and good stories, had a phone call Sunday night.
Right.
I just want to say a very, very g'day. Is that what they say in the country? G'day?
G'day,
mate.
I think they say it most.
G'day, mate.
Metropolitan areas.
Just want a couple of flights. G'day,
howdy
mate.
All.
Howdy all. Do they say howdy all here? I don't know. I just want to say g'day, mate, to Jack McDonald.
Outside of Bendigo.
How
do you know Jack?
Well, it's McDonald's Plum Farm.
How do you know him?
Well, I just got onto him last week. I'd heard about the stories of plum orchards out there outside Bendigo.
Mm.
Had a chat with him. And can I just say, you laugh at Jack's a real guy. Can I just say,
I think you're pretty.
Jack gave me a call on Sunday night.
Was he lonely?
Tight bunch. Well, no, he wasn't lonely. Apparently the bus did another stop on Sunday night.
Again.
The Mildura boys heading back to Orange County have gone through Plum County and the old plums have come out again and they've gone for another dash through Jack's property. Hey, can I just say, Jack's actually starting to get a little bit annoyed by it.
They had reason to celebrate, come on.
Well, they did. They got up in OT over Geelong. It was a very good effort.
They were pretty excited.
Well, they were excited. The old pitchforks were out with the plums at the same time. They were very, very excited, Mildura. Good on them.
Hopefully
one win away.
Oh, that's right.
And they'll get it.
Oh,
no disrespect to Geelong, but I'll tell you what.
Geelong had to win game one.
They had to win
it's
game one.
One of the toughest road trips going to Mildura. Oh. They're rowdy. They're a bit...
Hey, just quietly before we get into this week's game.
Yeah.
Have a guess, or the game just gone. Have a guess who's going to Orange County this week. Have a guess who the league, as its representative, is sending up to Orange County this weekend. We're got work to do. Have a guess who's getting sent up to Orange County.
Yeah.
Have a guess who's he's on his way.
Sure am.
And I believe...
Yeah.
Staying at Sammy Smythe's house this week.
Oh, that's all right.
Hey, nice work. You and Sammy hanging out.
Shacking up for the weekend.
Good. Nice work, you and Sammy Smythe.
Do you have to pay? Like, is it bed and breakfast or?
Sammy's charging the league.
Yeah.
Definitely charging the league. To all those people that joined us 5 minutes ago and have just heard an absolute load of crap, stick with us. Cracking game. Game one.
Yeah. Oh.
Mildura, 95-91 over Geelong in overtime.
Yeah, I was at our family birthday lunch and I just sat there the whole time.
Was Sammy with you?
No, that's next weekend.
Okay,
so you know what makes me happy about this?
Yeah.
The Division 1 men's competition has been phenomenal all year. And this game one, they had just about everything in it.
It was fitting.
It was absolutely fitting of the entire
absolutely.
Division. It's great.
Good work. Jermaine Williams, two free throws, a couple of seconds to go regular time. Mm-hmm. Forces it into overtime.
That's why you paid him big bucks.
He also hit another 6 points in the overtime period.
Yep.
Mildura get up by four.
Crazy. And Geelong actually led for, I think, two-thirds of the game as well.
Jermaine Williams, 35 points and 12 rebounds. Wow. Best performance of the week.
Perhaps don't you know even finished.
Oh, sorry. I'll also add in 6 assists and 4 blocks.
You can do that. Well.
Unguardable.
Brent Simons, 13 and 11. Good starting double. I'll tell you what, Labka.
Yeah.
He was all right. 12 points, 5 rebounds, 5 assists.
5 rebounds?
Yeah, no, it's gone up. 5 rebounds.
Career high.
5 assists. I'll let him know you said that. And 6 blocks.
That's a really good line. That's a really good line.
Chris Clark, 10 points, 8 rebounds, 6 assists, 4 steals.
11 turnovers,
unfortunately. But anyway, they got the win.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, Geelong had some winners on the day too.
Oh, absolutely.
It's not just about Mildura. Dane Bowe, 19 points, 5 assists. Brett, good game. Not a bad game. It was a big game. It was an alright game from Brett.
It was a finals game.
He got fouled off in overtime with about a minute and a half to go, and I think that sort of hurt Geelong a bit as well.
18
Brett Campbell's back when he goes out.
Yeah. 18 points. Steve Wysak, 13 and 12. Simon Evans, 11 points. Matthew Hardiman.
Mm-hmm.
I thought he played a great game. 16 points, 15 rebounds, 6 assists,
Gun show.
What was that?
He's got some arms.
Has he?
Beast.
Did you get
Rashawn,
that? 16.
Rashawn Weaver. Yeah, I heard you.
16 points, 15 rebounds, 6 assists, 4 steals.
Yeah.
I just don't want to steal his limelight.
No,
that's very good.
That's right.
Look, I don't think we can write off Geelong yet. I reckon, yeah, all season long, you know, they didn't even look like they were going to make the finals. You know, we talked about the players that they've lost, and, you know, they just kept proving people wrong. They were down against Hawthorn, they beat Hawthorn. Most people expected McKinnon to win, they beat McKinnon. You know, they almost got a game against Mildura.
You can't write them off.
Time and time again, they've proven us wrong, so no doubt they'll probably do it again.
Yep.
Mildura wins Saturday night, mate.
You reckon comfortably?
Mildura wins Saturday night. Yeah. Oh, well, I just look. Geelong have been very good. Look, it is a massive task to go up there
and win two
and win a couple games. It's just tough, it won't happen. It'll be packed there Saturday night. 800 people. I think last time Geelong were there, they lost by 20, 24 points, something like that. Take your hats off to Geelong.
Yep.
No disrespect to the team down there at all. Fantastic job.
Yep.
It would be an unbelievable achievement to go up there and
what they've got to do is they've just got to try and hang tough for that first quarter. You know, the longer that they can stay in the game.
Well, what they've got to do seriously. This is how you beat Mildura. This is how you beat them. Get up there a day earlier. Well, get up there on Friday. Get up there Friday. Find Jermaine Williams. Take him out for the night. And have a massive, massive night and make sure he doesn't get up until Sunday afternoon about
4:00. Drive him out to the country, tie him to an orange tree, and then just leave him there. Pick him up afterwards.
Well, you've got to do something, because he is a gun.
Absolutely.
It'll be the old boxing one on Jermaine Williams. Four on Jermaine and one on the other four.
There have been a couple of games, for example, earlier on in the season at home, Mildura lost to Southern Penn.
Yeah.
No one would have seen that coming, so you just don't know.
Game two, Saturday night, 7 p.m. at the Hot House, Mildura Basketball Stadium. 1 p.m. Sunday, if required. Now,
guys,
last week.
No, don't. You did this in the champ show.
Yeah, but it's.
Writes the notes, Justin? And don't lie to the people.
Nathan, tell us the truth here.
Cal forgot.
Yeah, there you go. Last week.
The referees who, without them, the game wouldn't go.
Last week, you were supposed to plug the grand final refs.
I'm going to get a lot of calls next season,
And you absolutely stuffed it up. In fact, you said before last week's show, I'm not mentioning
it. Yeah. Well, I just grabbed this because you'd thrown it on the ground.
I'm not mentioning them. They didn't do me any favours during the season. I'm not giving them jack.
Well, I'm doing it.
Let's go.
I'd love to. Well, guys, this is Division 1 men.
Can I just say, this is an honour for these people, by
the way. It is, because this is the only one that has a memorial trophy, the Dick Mason Memorial Trophy. Yeah, right, this is a big deal, mate.
It is.
Tim or Sal? Is Alex?
I'd say it's Alex.
Yeah.
That's too many.
Timmy.
And Bryce Reed.
Yeah, Timmy and Reed.
Great job. Obviously, they automatically get the Referee of the Year award for Division 1 men after being selected for the grand final.
That is a really good honour. Seriously, congratulations to them.
And you know, they had a bit to deal with in that game 1. I think they handled themselves very well.
God, he got out of that well. Been disrespecting them all season. All-star centres, here we go. I reckon the shortlist for D1 men, I apologise for the voice by the way, but Cal and I had a couple of big games to broadcast last week. We did a lot of talking. We broadcast two games.
You sounded really good.
I actually got a record 7 words in.
we broadcast two games back to back. I hope you all enjoyed it if you listened in. I hope you had a great time and enjoyed it. All-star centres, Kevin Anstey, the Big Perm. He was at Eltham last week, the Big Perm, by the way.
He was dressed for the occasion too, and his shorts on and his slippers, basically, and a t-shirt. It's about 5 degrees.
And Cam Mitchell. The three all-star centre. Have fun trying to sort that out. That'll be the short list.
Pimenta or Mitchell, I reckon.
Bring the Vultures out.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think they're a rung above. I reckon Perm.
Big Perm or Green Lantern? Big Perm?
Perm.
Perm.
Oh, I tell you what.
What about you?
Well, geez, the Green Lantern's been good.
He's been very good.
Are they getting him back? Are the Seahawks getting the Green Lantern back? I hope so.
I hope so for their sake, though. They need him.
We'll find out.
I reckon the Green Lantern might get up.
Yep. Okay. It's going to be close either way.
Coach of the Year. Here we go. I think the short list is going to be like this.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Chris Anstey, a.k.a. play 10 minutes, average 20 and 10.
Yeah.
Shane Bowe.
Did a great job.
Did a very good job. His mid-season break, he did excellent over there as well.
doesn't play.
What do you mean doesn't play?
You said Chris Anstey did.
Oh, okay, sorry.
Yeah.
James Madigan,
up there
at Mildura.
Okay. Yeah.
Very good season.
Yeah.
Arnie Gifning, one of the best coaches going around. Very good bloke, Arnie.
Well, no. He's a bit of a jerk. That's what just like, you know, that. That's what I heard from you.
I'm not. Oh,
because he doesn't mean that.
Well, that's why I was so surprised.
Hey, come on.
I'm like, you're from his club, and I was like, oh, well, that's.
If you're gonna be a dick and you're gonna dig a hole for yourself, have fun trying to get out of it right now.
I'm just saying that's what you said to me, and I said that was a bit rough considering you're from the same club. It's appalling.
You know what?
Just don't. Arnie's a top guy, come on.
And you know what? Arnie would sit there and watch this right now, and there'd be one story he's believing, and it's not yours.
Why?
You've just made a fool of yourself.
But why wouldn't he believe me?
You wanted to come and play for us next season.
Because he's the guy that gives him the job.
You wanted to come and play for us next season, and I reckon you just shot yourself in the foot.
He is that hard up.
Warren Dock Force in 2013.
And Paul Jones is the other.
He did a great job with a really young team, getting them to compete.
Of course, Werribee. So there you go, Coach of the Year, Chris Anstey, Shane Bowe, James Madigan, Arnold Giffening, who you have just slagged off on this show, by the way, and he won't forget that, Paul Jones.
Yeah.
Who do you reckon?
Madigan.
Oh yeah, good call.
Can I tip three?
Great season.
Oh yeah, by all means, tip three. There'll only be one winner.
Bo Madigan or Jones.
Oh, hey, Bo's a pretty good candidate.
Hey, what if
good guy.
Yeah, he's very good.
Oh, doesn't make a difference.
Shouts at the bar in Thailand too.
Well, he's a good guy, but it doesn't make a sort of bearing on this as a non-boss.
So if you're a captain or coach and had to re-vote and there was someone you didn't like, you would vote for
him? Yeah, human nature.
Can I just ask, what if the votes are the same? What if someone ends up on the same amount of votes?
Goes to a count back on threes, yeah.
What if it's the same?
Then it's a tie.
Count back on twos? What if it's the same? Count back once. On ones, then what do?
Get another trophy.
Right, okay, good.
Joint winners.
MVP, well, you've just mentioned three, so maybe you've given something away there. Maybe it's a three-way tie.
Are you saying I know?
Maybe it's a threesome. Maybe we've got a threesome for Coach of the Year, for D1 men.
You'd like that.
Is that what you're saying?
Hello.
MVP, Russell Permenter, Jermaine Williams. Have a listen to this list.
Yeah, I know.
Manny Hendricks, Cam Mitchell, Jordan Hughes.
That
just
is
pick one.
That's Timo.
Now Timo didn't make the shortlist.
Come on!
Just give me one of those players.
Manny Hendricks.
Well, I've said Manny Hendricks all season.
Actually, no, I'm going to change.
Come on.
Okay, well, don't worry about it.
Who are you going to change to?
No, it doesn't matter.
Who are you going to change to?
You don't want to hear it. You don't want to hear it. You shot me down.
Big I'm sook. Not tipping.
What?
I'm not tipping in this one.
Why not?
Because I know.
Oh, okay. Oh, he knows the answer.
Wow.
Yeah. So let's just see his facial reactions here. You ready? Because you can always tell by the way he looks. No, take that down. So the MVPs are Russell. No, he's getting just nothing. All right. Who are you going for? Going Manny. Manny?
I'm going to
D1 women. Oh, by the way, who wins this week? Mildura, Geelong. What happens game two, first of all?
Be a sellout of Brooms down in Mildura, I think.
Sweet. I'm going Mildura.
Yeah, I don't know.
Oh, come on. You're going up to Orange County. You're shit scared of the locals by the sounds of it.
Yeah, I've been told by a certain coach that I'm not allowed to tip his team for the rest of this year.
It's been a good omen.
Who was that?
Madigan.
Nah, that's crap. That's rubbish, all right? You're the one that's been feeding us all the stories of the plums out in Bendigo and all that sort of stuff. You've been telling us everything going on. Now, that's enough. You have got to give us a tip right now, and if you think Mildura, say Mildura, and Jimmy Madigan, bad luck, sunshine.
Mildura in three.
In three?
Yeah.
So Geelong to get Saturday night? Yeah. That's what you seriously think?
I really do.
Okay. All right. No worries.
Bench there.
Craigieburn 67 defeated Warrnambool 65. Great game.
What a game for Craigieburn to get up. Warrnambool have been in such good form.
What a great win.
Warrnambool 36-27 at half time. Oh, I saw the stats at half time. We brought it up at our commentary.
Yes, we did.
Yeah, our commentary was very good last week, by the way.
Phenomenal.
I heard it. Did you hear it?
Yep.
Did you hear it?
I thought you sounded great.
You got to just hear it. You were sitting down a couple of rows.
Yeah, that's the only reason I could hear it. I was sitting right in front of you.
36-27 at half time.
Is the sound rubbish?
Is the sound going to be working this week on the broadcast?
Only if your voice is.
The voice will be all right. Well, the sound.
Try and understand it.
Everyone keep your fingers crossed for us. New technology.
Oh, yeah. For the three people that want to tune in, just keep your fingers crossed.
That's it.
Actually, can I just say, even without the sound, there was a lot of people that came and watched the game on the website.
It was massive.
It was massive.
And the pitch quality was really good.
Very, very good.
Fantastic.
Crisp. It's good.
You know what, people? The one thing in that champ game, watching the game, they kept coming back and saying, oh, I loved it when I saw this. I loved it when I saw this. D-Max block on Skyler Boland.
I think I'm kind of glad that that the audio didn't work because I went a bit crazy.
Yeah, no, you did.
I went pretty dark.
You love
it. I sounded like Andrew Gaze when I got excited. I was like, oh, D-Mac off the glass. And it was a little bit Drewy-like, and it was. And that's okay though.
Don't compare yourself to the great man, mate. It just doesn't happen.
The Australian basketball god. You are not.
Don't compare yourself to the great man.
He was similar.
You know what he'll be saying next time he hears Drew doing commentary? Hey, he sounds a bit
like me.
He does.
Warrnambool 36-27 at half time. The Eagles had just hit 6 points in the second quarter. They went 1 of 19 in the second quarter. When I saw those stats, I thought, here we go.
Yeah, especially Craigieburn led by a beat in the first quarter, and then you see Warrnambool up by that much, and you kind of think, ah, they've been so good, the Mermaids, they're probably going to go on with it. But full credit to Craigieburn, what a result.
And that is, and I agree with you, full credit, because when you have a down quarter in a game, especially letting into halftime, it's very, very easy to come out and just slide away.
Especially against a team that has been doing as well as the Mermaids.
Very good, the Eagles. They just put that quarter behind them, and that's what good teams do. They go, okay, get it out of the way.
And they would have had the crowd.
We can't change it. Get it out of the way. Let's just refocus on what we're here to do.
They're going to win this series. They needed to win that game.
And they did.
And 23-12 third quarter.
Yep.
That got him back into the game. Ali McLean ended up with 16-10. Tennille Keane 18 points. Julia D'Annunzio 13-9. Holly Green 20-7. Katie O'Keefe 14-11. Kate Saul 9-13.
So all the stars come out.
Yeah, absolutely.
Darcy Saunders was probably of the quartet. Was behind the other three. Ali McLean, Tennille Keane, Julia D'Annunzio. Kelly Green didn't get right up in the points with the others.
Holly Green was a little bit cold from the field. I think she shot a lowish clip. But apart from that, I think everyone else was pretty good. It'd be interesting to see how they got home.
Well, we said last week, Craigieburn must get game one.
They had to.
If they are any chance. You know what? They're now a chance.
Oh, you're going with every shot.
They are now a chance.
Absolutely.
Yeah. It is very hard to go to Warrnambool and win two games.
They only need to win one.
But it's much easier to go to Warrnambool and win one.
Absolutely.
So chance. I think Warrnambool gets Saturday night. I think this will go into Sunday.
Yep.
I really think this will go into Sunday.
You're right.
Well, the rest of this, the game on Saturday night, 6 o'clock.
We apologise on behalf of Kel last week for dissing you. Come on, who are they?
Hopefully I have short memories sitting in the start till March. Caleb Wersma and David Lawson will be the
two. Who are they?
Oh, well, don't worry about it. You talk while
Caleb
I was in there.
And David Lawson.
While I was in there, you didn't care. You treat him with contempt and I'm over it.
All-star centres. Who wins Saturday night, by the way? It's taking you 20 weeks to be over it, has it? 20 weeks.
I think Warrnambool wins Saturday night, Craigieburn in 3.
Come on, you
big if Craigie weren't going to do it, they'll do it, have to do it on the Saturday night. And I think they'll
win. You think they will?
So you're going to think they're sweet.
Craigie going to win Saturday night and sweep?
If they're going to do it, it has to happen on the Saturday night, and I think they will. But Craigie if they lose Saturday, it's Warrnambool's.
Craigieburn wins D1 women, will they go to champ?
Well, they have to look at it, don't they? I think they absolutely could.
You've got Tennille Keane that would be an all-star going.
And like if you do,
to it, I think that'd be alright.
And if you do as well if they do as well as they did in Division One women, you know, they have the courage to go up to championship and have a crack at it.
I reckon they will. But with a game that good, 67-65, from all accounts, the standard is phenomenal. Wouldn't both of them look at going up?
You'd have to look.
I think so. And look, I saw the state champ women's game on the weekend. Yeah. Obviously, I'd watch D1 women throughout the season. There's probably more than two teams in D1 women that could go to state champ women next season, to be honest with you, and compete.
Like who, mate?
I'm just saying there's more than those two.
Are you coaching D1 women?
I think there's more than those two, that's all I'm saying.
And you know what? If you're going to go up to champ...
Don't read between the lines or anything.
Look, you may not necessarily come up and make the top four in your first season, but if you can go up and have a good competitive season where, you know, you win a third to half of your games, and then you put the building blocks in place to be a regular champ team in the future, surely for your program you've got to look at that.
Swallow your pride and do it.
Hey, I said in a article a few weeks ago, of the last five seasons, the five teams that have won D1 women, the five teams that have won D1 men, only one of those 10 teams has bit the bullet and gone, you know what, we're going to take our club to the next level, and that was Diamond Valley Women. And I reckon they've done really well.
They've been very good.
Sensational.
Yeah, absolutely.
Sensational.
Game 2, Saturday, 6 p.m, Warrnambool Basketball Stadium, 1:30 Sunday if required. Yep. You're going Craigieburn to win Saturday, clean sweep, see you later, Warrnambool. Mm. There was one goose out of us three geese about three rounds into the season
Really? Again?
Oh, yeah, end of the season.
I get emails from the Warrnambool team.
Wrote Warrnambool off.
Absolutely.
He's made a massive mistake. He's been begging for forgiveness ever since. He's been down at Whale Bay praying on the sand for forgiveness. You've just written him off, young man. You reckon they're going to get done in a clean sweep?
Look, I think if Craig Brown can do a Saturday night, then if Warrnambool get it on Saturday night, it will be Warrnambool's, but I think just have the psychological edge. Yeah, and yet you sit here and ask us who you think's going to win, and you just sit here. And you do it all the time.
Oh, no, I'm going to tell you in a minute. So you're going Craigie Burnie in 2.
Yeah. You're going Warrnambool in 3.
I'm going Warrnambool in 3. I reckon Warrnambool go home and get both.
I'm going Craigie Burnie in 3.
Right, there you go. So we're all different.
That's great.
In terms of how we think it's going to
match. So diverse.
All-star centres.
Yep.
I think the shortlist is going to look like this. Bridget Ardossi.
Yep.
Tash Ross-Harris. Emmy O'Neill and Kate Sewell.
Ardossi for mine.
By the way.
Oh, yeah.
Kel's been very hard at work with his crayons and he's come up with this. There you go. Yeah, nice.
Come to the dinner, it's going to be a ripper night.
There you go, Kel. Yeah, jiggle it around so no one can read it. Good on you.
You did that before.
These two are getting a bit testy with each other as the season goes on.
You should have seen us Saturday night.
Bit of burst.
You should have seen us Saturday night. Man, it was great.
Just smacked you over the head with my headset.
Calm down, guys.
Thanks, man.
It was good.
It was good.
Yeah, you did well. Glad everyone out there heard it. Bridget Ardossi, Tash Ross-Harris, Emmy O'Neill, Kate Sewell, who
you Ardossi.
Ardossi, surely. So a big season, mate.
Okay, alright.
Who are you going for?
I think the best two over the course of the season there are Ardossi and Kate Sewell. Kate Sewell's very good centre.
Yep.
Yeah, he's your cousin. You and Kate are related. Mm-hmm. Kate's been very good. I reckon it's out of those two. Maybe Ardossi just.
I reckon Ardossi.
But I reckon it's out of those two.
Yeah.
Coach of the Year, here we go. Simon Liebel.
Yep.
From Craigieburn, of course. Darren Bissittle.
Mm-hmm.
Is that pronounced right?
Yeah, I think so.
Bissittle. Yep. From Geelong. Joe Bruins from Latrobe City.
Had a great season.
Lester Pickett from Warrnambool.
How are you doing?
Shannon Bodley from Whittlesea.
You skip one.
And someone else. Coach of the Year, who gets it?
No, who's someone else?
Well, okay, all right, my name's Justin. It doesn't matter. All right, Coach of the Year.
Justin Nelson. Jeez, he's just so humble.
You think
I'll win
it?
Thanks for being.
Who are you going for?
Well, not you. that's damn sure. At least we got it narrowed down to 5. I'm going with...
Why is my name being written on here in blood? Is there a reason for that, or...?
Because it pained us to put you on the list.
Very good. Who do you think wins it? Coach of the Year.
Oh,
I know who I voted for, so I probably shouldn't say anything.
Liebel's got to look at it. It's got to have a look. I reckon they've had a very good season.
Well, he'll probably look at it, whether he gets given it or not. I don't know. Who are you going for?
Well, who do you think? I just said
it. Liebel. Who are you going for?
Pickett coming late and has done a good job with Warrnambool a few weeks very before good. The season starts.
Wow, did a very good job post round 3.
Yeah, exactly.
Very good
after round 3, he's been all. If it's
lulled
you right. Come after round 3, it's Pickett.
He lulled you into a false sense of security and then bang.
That's right. I don't think you can write off Joe Bruins either. Latrobe City.
Joe Bruins has been very good. Yeah. We spoke about him as well.
Anyone's a worthy winner in that. That's
anyone?
Well, except for this guy.
MVP, here we go. Bridget Ardossi, Tennille Cairn, Jamie Lee Pierce, JLP, Holly Green, the Green Machine, and Katie O'Keefe, very, very fit this season.
Tennille Cairn, me.
Yeah, go back and watch the early shows in the season. I was on the Cairn bandwagon from the start.
And you know who I love?
The Cairn wagon.
Very good. You know who I love, don't you? Out of those players, you know who I love.
Oh, you, the fitness.
You know who I love.
Well, you reckon she's fit?
She's very good player.
She's fit.
Someone with two young kids, she's had an absolutely sensational season.
What are you trying to say? But she had kids and forgot how to play basketball?
No. But to come back from that, she's...
They got their own corner down there at the Warrnambool Stand. They go in with the crayons and the Play-Doh and all
she's
that sort of stuff.
Phenomenal. She hasn't lost it at all.
She's been great. Fit.
You're going Craigieburn. I'm going Warrnambool.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Mildura. Have fun at Sammy Smyth this week, by the way.
Can't wait.
Have fun.
Yeah, it's going to be a rock.
There's a little shark on the hill.
Will you guys go out and dinner date together?
Oh, we'll hit the town.
Great.
Big night.
Town's looking forward
to shandies.
Have a great week. Don't forget, Big VTV.
Wow.
Silly season.
Next week.
If this hasn't already started. Next week, right here. Enjoy the grand finals. Good luck
to all.
Thanks
for watching.
See you later.
See ya. Ain't no stopping us now.